access band. In the next few minutes, we're going to be talking about this massively successful initiative at Access Bank called the Learning Binge. And more importantly, we'll also talk about some inspiration for looking at learning at the speed of digital. Are we ready for this journey?
Yes.
All right, let's get started. So those of you who know me really well know that I'm an avid quizzer. So I'm going to quiz you. Right, first 5 minutes is going to be interactive. Who's this? It's obviously a robot, but who is this?
I think it's a cop robot.
Okay, can we award him 100 virtual points that you can redeem at the popcorn counter outside? So this is the world's first robotic cop to be introduced where?
UAE.
In UAE. Great going. 50 points to you. Alright, so this is the world's first robotic cop in Dubai. What is this? What are we looking at? What are we looking at? It is not a vending machine.
It's an ATM.
It's an ATM, but what's unique about it?
Retina scanner.
It is the first, world's first Bitcoin ATM in Canada, where you can redeem Bitcoins and get real money. What is this?
It's a chip there.
It's a microchip implant inside a human body. Why would companies do this?
To gain access. And
this is for access control at this point in time, but you know what's going to happen next? Your employee engagement surveys will be dead because you can read the person's emotions while he's walking into the office. Is he enthusiastic? Is he passionate? Or is he dead on arrival? Right? That's where the future is heading. So humans with microchip implants, I look forward to the day where we can download Wikipedia on this implant and we wouldn't have to learn anything more. What's going on here? Champions Trophy, which happened recently. If you watched that series, you would know this.
A chip inside the bag.
Absolutely right. 100 points to you as well. Popcorn is waiting for you. So this is Intel Inside. For the longest time, we've known Intel to be inside our PCs, our laptops, maybe some phones, but now Intel is inside our cricket bats, tennis rackets, soccer balls, right? So this is the era of Internet of Things. So why am I starting with this? Digital is upon us, it is real, it is here and now, it is not out there. And today, you will find a lot of leaders and talent in general struggling with digital, mainly because many of the lines that we are used to from the information age and the industrial age, these lines are blurring away. Now, what are these lines? First, industries and organizations are becoming boundaryless. Right? There's no formal definition anymore, so that's causing fuzziness in our heads. Second, there is a lot of permissionless innovation or lawless innovation that's happening. The line between what is legal and what is lawless, right? That is blurring away. Ubiquitous digitalization, the line between physical and digital is blurring away as well. And finally, robotics, which is the difference between the human being and the machine, the man-machine convergence, right? That's happening as well. So in this era of digital blur, as HR professionals and learning leaders, what can we do? How do we prepare for the era of the blur? We believe that we can prepare for this era of the blur by being learner-centric, by keeping pace with what's happening out there. And for that, we need to operate in an on-demand fashion. We need to be adaptive and we need to be engaging as well in whatever we do with our employees. So when Kavita and I sat together brainstorming for Learning Binge, we came up with certain basic rules. How do we set up this new age learning system? How do we prepare the employees at Access Bank for the future? We came up with very simple rules. First, it is better to build better learners than better learning systems. How many of us have installed a brand new LMS with 5% adoption? Many of us. You know what I'm talking about. The problem is not with the learning ecosystem. The problem is that we are not focusing on the learner. So we said we'll start with design thinking, right? We'll start with learners first. Second, learning should be integrated with your work process. As long as learning remains a destination that you go to, or you go to this LMS and learn, that model is broken. We need to integrate learning with your normal work process, right? So that it becomes seamless. Third, we need to enable choice for learners. This is something that we are used to as consumers. We are flooded with choice and we are happy about it. The same thing needs to happen inside the organization for our employees. One size fits none. The gap between learning and performance needs to be obliterated, because today these are two different silos. How can we bring it together so that that question around ROI of learning goes away forever? You invest something in learning and you see the returns. And finally, engage, empower, and enable new age learners through personalized learning. Ultimately, it's about personalization. What automation could mean to me could be very different from what it means to you. So how can we use machine learning and artificial intelligence to make learning truly personal? These were some of the basic rules that we started with, and what we ended up with was a mind-blowing experience, and I'll invite Kavita to wow you with the details.
Rajiv and I, you know, started the conversation about doing something different where learning was concerned. One thing that we realized was that last year around this time, there were a lot of these binges during the round. People were binging on food, Netflix had just come, so all the conversations around the water cooler was, you know, I binged watch this and I binged watch that. So that's when I called him up 45 days before the launch, and I told him, you know what, on this date I'm going to launch, on 1st of August, I'm going to launch a learning binge where people across the organization are going to binge on learning. So we are going to be giving them different ways of learning and make them realize that learning is an ongoing activity and is something that you can do in the most mundane of things. So we had a series of events that happened across the organization, right from hobby appreciation, we had opera appreciation, we had nature walks, we had city talks, we had master classes. But then we said we need to take it to the next step, and that's when we said, how is it that we can tell people that learning is beyond face-to-face interaction in a classroom where someone is standing up on a podium and teaching down to you. Learning also needs to be self-directed, and people need to move from knowledge to doing, move from knowing to doing. And that's when we said, let's look at four or five ways that things are changing around the world and what can we do to help people realize that this is how you can learn on your own and it can be super fun. That's when we came up with a learning binge, and we said, what are the latest things that are happening in the learning space or not? And we said, okay, so Rajiv gave me a list of things. He said, AI, VR, machine learning, gamification, and I said, fine, let's do all of them. So we came up with modules for each one of them. So we looked at onboarding, and we said, okay, let's do a 360 virtual reality experience. So the moment someone comes into the organization and fills out his account opening formalities, he gets a headset, goes into a room, sits down, and goes through what it means to walk into the Access House at Mumbai, interact with some of the senior leaders, and get a sense of the ethos that's doing the rounds. Then we said, okay, customer service is something that's very core to us at the bank. We said, let's build an AI-based simulation that will allow people to gauge how good they really are at customer service. So we had senior leaders come down, put this up, and we asked them questions beforehand, saying, how good do you think are you in solving this customer query? There is a query and you have to go through it, and at the end of it, we'll tell you whether the customer was satisfied or not. All of them gave us huge scores, and at the end of it, they were quite surprised at some of the scores that came up. So it is very, very interesting. Another very interesting one we did was a simulation around having difficult performance conversations. So we said, okay, so you have a difficult conversation. It allows you to practice how the person will feel. Why? You get a score at the end of it. So you might think you've done a great job, but at the end of it, if your score is still red, then clearly the person doesn't think you've done a great job. So it just allows you to practice that. We had performance-based learning as another app, and then, of course, game-based learning. We had a series of little games where people went back to Pac-Man and tried out different things and said, oh, you can learn in this way as well. In the month, we did 70 lakh hours of learning. We covered 45,000 employees, and we showcased this as a roadshow across 25 cities. So we actually traveled city to city and invited people to come in and go through these experiences. Post the learning binge, the uptake of learning within the organization has gone up tremendously. In 2014, where we were averaging about 1.8 man days of learning, last year we did 8 days of learning per person. And this doesn't include the 70 lakh hours of learning that we did with the learning bridge. This year we are hoping to reach about 12 days. And all of this is self-directed learning. I don't mandate learning at all in Access. We very clearly believe that except for the RBI-led regulated learning, all other learning should be user-driven. If they want to learn, we have the frameworks and they can come and learn. So these are some of the images of people very intently doing the learning bit. That's where the VR bit was there. We actually had one of our employees be the avatar, and a lot of them removed and they were like, "Isko to abhi andar dekha tha." And we were like, "Yeah, that's a simulation. She's a real life person. It's not a bot that we have." Yeah, we actually had a lot of HR people had to stand around and literally pull people away saying there's a line of people waiting to try it out. We will come back. Can you please give others a shot at what's the latest in learning? We have a demo, so we have some things that we'd like to show to the larger audience, but we welcome that there is a huge LED screen. And then we just walk on. It was super fun making the video. We had to record with about 18 cameras at one shot. And we had to do the entire shoot from end to end in one shot. You can't break a video when you're doing a 360 shoot. So it was great fun.
And you can create hotspots within the video for people to click on, explore more. You can, layer some challenges on top of it.
So you actually have to swipe your ID card in the simulation to gain access into the building, as you would in real life. That's the lobby. And then Swati, of course, is explaining about the products and a little bit about the bank. Walking up is our chief economist. And then he engages in conversation with the person who's coming on board. So Rajiv has promised in the next version they'll actually be able to shake hands virtually. So what we've tried to do is in about 10 minutes put together the entire overview of the organization and also give them access to the senior leaders within the organization and wrap up what would normally take about 4 to 5 boring presentations and clicks of the down arrow spread over 2 days. So the remaining 2 days are then spent in actually having conversations with other leaders, understanding what their role is about, but the overview and the context of the organization gets done using.
Alright, we can pause the video here. We'll move on to the next demo. So it's not a demo, but it's just a screenshot that will give you a good sense of what we did using AI for this very interesting ritual that we do every year called performance appraisal. Right? You remember the time when you are supposed to give feedback to the employees and nobody has any clue how to do that? Right? So anxiety levels are up. So we thought, how can we make this fun? How can we make this learning effective in a safe learning environment where the manager can have this conversation in a safe setting, learn from the mistakes so that in real life you have some effective conversations? So that's this one. Kavita, you want to talk about this?
Yeah. So here you actually have someone, so you go through the entire process of doing the conversation and it keeps telling you whether or not the person's happy with the responses that you're giving and whether he's satisfied with the appraisal conversation that's happened. This was typically focused around the difficult conversations. So we didn't have a sim for the happy conversations. We assumed people could take care of that. But for the difficult conversations, Rajiv and his team managed to put something together, which was extremely successful. This year in February, I was flooded with calls saying, can you get that sim back? We'd like to start practice right now. So that come April, it's going to be easier for us.
Yeah, so if you notice, while you're having this conversation with this virtual character, you're getting some insights. Maybe you can smile a little more, you can build trust, maybe you want to be more empathetic. So these are some tips that are coming your way real time. And this is the feedback we all need when it comes to building professional skills. This feedback is sorely missing in real world, but today with artificial intelligence, you're able to build that, and not only build that and create a personal experience, you're able to do this at scale. right? All your employees can get the benefit of doing this. It's like having a personalized Siri who will teach you how to have effective conversations. Right, so how do we prepare for the digital age? Clearly, digital is upon us. A lot of technologies are here and now. We've heard Kavita talk about the fantastic success we've had at Access Bank. So how do we generalize from here, and what are some three things that we can take away? One, the weakest link in digital transformation today is talent readiness. Technology is there, opportunities are there, but what we are missing is talent readiness. Second, when we talk about digital mastery from an organization perspective or even from a personal perspective, you will see the simple equation, right? Digital strategy plus digital capabilities plus culture leads to outcomes. Out of these three things, two are directly under the control of HR. Can you identify the two? Capabilities and culture, right? So that's directly in our control. So that's something that we can act upon today and be leaders. And last but not the least, machines are learning. Are we? The biggest difference that we see in the way systems are learning, and we have connected cars, we have robots taking over human jobs. The reason that is happening at this rapid pace is that machines are learning at a furious pace. We can't be left behind. So we need to find a way to make this happen. And here's an example of how we made that happen. I hope you found this interesting and useful. Happy to have a chat after this talk. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Rajiv. Thank you, Kavita.